On a peaceful day, a controller checked an aircraft that landed on runway 20 is entering the intersection taxiway and issued landing clearance to a landing aircraft approaching runway 20 in the final 6 miles. What on earth happened? The aircraft entering the intersection taxiway suddenly stopped. That's because the aircraft had a bird strike. Unfortunately, this aircraft stopped without being vacated from the runway completely. The controller immediately instructed the final aircraft to go around. However, there was no response from the aircraft. There was no answer even after the second and third calls. There must be some problems in the communication system. Will the pilot make his own decision of going around by finding the aircraft that has not been vacated from the runway? If the pilot just lands without noticing the current situation, won't this situation lead to an accident? At this moment, a controller should first fire the gun. This gun, though it's a gun, fires the light, not the bullet. This is called a light gun the control tower possesses by signaling with the light to control an aircraft, vehicle, and people whose radio communication does not work. It has 3 buttons of red, green, and white, and it can transfer the signal to 5 nautical miles, with each signal meaning as the following graph. Though the aircraft's transmitter has a problem, it might be able to receive the controller's instructions. In order to check this, the controller can request a visual response from the aircraft using phraseology, such as acknowledging by rocking wings and acknowledging by flashing landing lights. However, if the aircraft doesn't respond, the controller and the pilot have to be connected with the signal of the light gun. Let's go back to the previous case. What kinds of light gun signals does this situation need to make the aircraft go around? The answer is to flash red signal. Doing this requires clicking the red button. This signal needs to be fired continuously until the aircraft goes around. Let's have a look at one more case. What if an aircraft finds a vehicle crossing the taxiway while taxiing without permission from the control tower? In this situation, the controller can flash red signal and steady red alternatively. Of course, there is much secondary communication system to deal with radio failure, which is used first, so the light gun is the last option. Nevertheless, if it is due to a problem with the aircraft's communication equipment, use the light gun first. What does the controller need to be careful about dealing with the light gun? First, the controller should not feel easy after shooting the light gun by simply believing that the pilot must have seen the signal. There is always a possibility that the pilot cannot recognize the light gun signal, even by the location and direction of the aircraft, vehicles and person, or by the influence of strong sunlight and weather. Therefore, the controller needs to fully prepare for the emergency from loss of communication and be aware of the light gun as just one of the safety systems. Second, on every shift, the controller always needs to check whether the light gun works properly and its battery is enough. There can be a situation where you think, will there be a situation of communication loss today? And then you encounter a real situation, but your light gun doesn't work. Third, it is good to let the vehicles and people that are not familiar with the runway and taxiway know the necessary signal earlier just in case they lose communication with the controller. The gun to save, not to kill the people. This is it for the light gun. Please subscribe and like the video. It's a good help to make the next video. ATC for you.